All right, okay then. What's going on, guys? Brandon Hutton here. Hope you're having a great day. Today is a Wednesday, and it's a better Wednesday than any Wednesday I've experienced in the past few months because of the fact that today I got confirmation that next Tuesday, the entire Take Flight collection is going to be dropping for Hardbody. This is season 2 of the Hardbody clothing drops. Previously, we had the Perfect collection, which was season 1, and now we have the Take Flight collection, which is going to be dropping at 6 p.m. UK time on the 28th of March. You may have realized that when I was getting ready this morning, going through the entire morning routine, that I was actually wearing 4 different outfits. And if you didn't realize that I was wearing 4 outfits, then you've been watching way too much TikTok and your attention span has gone down to 4 seconds. But if that is the case, it's okay. I forgive you. I've been watching a little bit too much myself as well, to be fair. Now, for the rest of the video, we're going to be breaking down a few things and talking about which show I have picked to do my first ever pro show, because of the fact that I don't want it to be this sort of thing where, like, I just leave it off for too long and, like, people don't really know what goal I'm sort of aiming for or what date I'm aiming for. And the show that I have picked is very, very cool, and it's kind of got a very special place in my heart already. I feel like the stars have aligned and sort of, like, place this show in front of me. I'm going to break it down and the reason why a little bit later on in the video. And I'm also going to be giving a bit of a hair transplant update, because it has been about 4 to 5 months since the transplant now, and the hairs are actually really, really, really starting to grow in, and I'm starting to notice a lot of progress. Let's go. Hey, okay. Oh, God. On the topic of hair as well, I'm gonna go over, like, the front growth, like, later in the video, but can you see that? Like, all of that growing at the back? Being 26 years old, I feel like hair's gonna grow slower and slower, like, and be a little bit less thick as life goes on. So I'm like, you know what? For one time in my life, if I can grow long hair, it's probably gonna be now. And we're making some good freaking progress.
Hey, question. Yeah. What do you think about me having long hair?
I like it. It's a flow. It gives you a different look. It's like I have a new boyfriend.
That's not good.
And if it doesn't suit me, guess what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go straight to the barbers, get a short freaking back and sides, get a fresh fade, and go back and reset back to freaking default.
Is that you?
I was gonna say back to level 1, yeah, it's pretty funny.
Give us a progress update.
Hello and welcome to my new clothing headquarters. That's not finished yet, but if you guys saw in Brandon's last video.
It is, like, the last video, yeah.
Yeah, so you saw stuff up to literally here. It's completely empty. It's been cleaned, it's been completely gone through. We've gone through all the stuff. We have our keepsakes, we have our stuff that we've donated to a bunch of different charities around the area, and then we're gonna paint it, and then we're gonna make it into a massive HQ.
Because when me and Jordy stay in Canada, we stay, like, in the basement, and connected to the basement area where we live is obviously this humongous storage that was basically like a hoarder's safe haven. I've called Jordy's mom a hoarder. She knows she is. She's in massive denial. It's fine. It's really, really cool to see this cleared out. And someone actually dropped a comment on the most recent video being like, we know who wears the shoes now. You're supporting Jordy's dreams, and, you know, it's all about her now, and, like, you're not gonna be concentrating any time on your own stuff. I'm like, all I do is concentrate on myself and my own life and different things. If I'm able to support Jordy and her goals and her dreams in any way whatsoever, I'm gonna do that. I actually replied to the comment and said, have you not seen the hundreds, if not thousands, of hours that Jordy's committed of her time to Hardbody? So me concentrating, a little bit of mental effort or whatever, helping Jordy take pictures for a brand or whatever with this, that's how a successful relationship or marriage or whatever flourishes. Like, you have to be there to support your partner, your friend, your family members, your brother, your sister. You know, it can't always be about you. You have to support people in your life and bring them up, because otherwise, if you don't do that, you're going to be concentrating so much on yourself, and I guarantee that sometimes people are going to be left behind. But the people that you want to bring up, the people that are close to you in your life and you care about, you got to do your best to involve them in everything. You can concentrate so much on yourself that you can forget what's important, and then you'll have all these things you want. You'll have all this success, because there's no way someone can dedicate 5, 10, 15, 20 years to something and not be successful. You will be successful, but there's a good chance that if you do that, you'll be completely alone in your success, and nobody wants to do that. Yeah. Whoever commented that, shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up.
Right, so the bag is all packed for the outfits I'm going to be shooting right now. Got it out of the box where all the clothing is. Pre-workout meal has been created. We've got chicken rice and sweet chili sauce. We're driving to the location now to get some pictures. It's in Burlington. It's on the way to the gym, to be honest, because the gym, Pure Muscle and Fitness, is also in Burlington. So when the shots are done, we can go straight to the gym and hit the leg day. On the topic of shooting, Jordy has booked out a studio for Saturday, and we're going to be doing her very first ever shoot as well. I've got loads of things happening. You'll see as, like, it sort of, like, unfolds over the next few weeks, over the next few months, and all the things that are happening this year. But it's really, really cool that at the same time, Jordy's also going to be having launches and things as well, because usually it's kind of just me having someone else doing it too. It's good to see, because I'm all about, like, starting their journey, starting posting on social media, starting to believe in their own potential and what they can do. And, like, when anyone starts the gym, they start their bodybuilding journey, seeing someone go from nothing and turn into something is really, really cool. So I'm here for it. All right, so we just got to the spot. Ideally, the gate behind us would have been open so we could actually access the top of this parking garage, but there's some pretty cool railings. We're gonna utilize that, and we're at the top, right by the sea, actually. Or I say the sea, but it's not. It's just a massive lake. The Lake of Ontario is probably one of the only lakes in the world that looks like the ocean. I literally thought it was the ocean. I might include some of the pictures that we do get in the vlog so you can see what we got, but obviously I need the camera to take the pictures, so I can't really record it, so. Right, we just pulled outside the gym, pretty happy with what we managed to get. We got a couple pictures, a couple reels, maybe like a compilation reel or like individual stuff. I'm not sure, too sure how I'm gonna like mash it together yet for Instagram. But it's not just the launch planning that has to be done. It's everything after that. It's making sure that you have enough content for your brand continuously over the months past launch, so you have like stuff to remind people if there is any stock left. But to be honest, with the stuff and the way it looks, I'm not sure that there will be. But we just pulled up to the gym, so we're gonna get the gym stuff out. I'm definitely gonna need the pre-workout meal because I am absolutely freaking starving. Pretty dead, to be fair, but we just heated the meal. We've got good old chicken and rice covered in sweet chili sauce, as I said earlier. Jordy was kind of getting the meal ready for us when we were leaving, and she was like pouring the sweet chili sauce, and I was like, whoa, it might be off season, but I already feel like a bag of milk. Like, I don't want to feel like even more of a bag of milk. Bathroom, I'm gonna try and not shit myself.
You can't shit yourself. I have a set next.
This
no poop.
Be dirty, innit?
This is no poop alert.
Kind of like a nasty thought. How many people every single day do you think that train legs shit themselves just a bit? Hands down, swear on my life, I've never shit myself.
Lies.
I've done a leg press and like farted once. But I was alone in the gym, that's the thing. Like, no one heard. It was an embarrassment free zone. Like, girls deadlift and sometimes piss themselves. Isn't it a thing? And you know this, because I know, when some girls train abs. Yeah, I knew you were gonna say it. If they do certain exercises, like for example, perfect example, is
leg
like
raises.
Is a hanging leg raise. Some girls will actually orgasm training abs.
I have.
Man, if you ever see a girl in the gym training abs, she's either doing it for abs or she's doing it for a totally different reason. I think this is common knowledge.
Yeah.
I think.
Also, sometimes when people do calves.
Calves? Really? Is every exercise like not for the muscle you're training? Either way, I can confirm that I've never done an exercise in the gym in my entire life and got any sort of arousement. I just feel pain. Only pain. You guys are just weird.
Do set.
No, I've got to take this seriously. What did Arnold say? Like, the bump is better than coming. Thank you.
All right, so right now it's a little bit in the future and we are currently about to get the website flat lay pictures because the studio that we were gonna use kind of fell through. Like the person just kind of started replying to me. I think I just like messaged them too much. So we are literally doing it our freaking self. I was gonna shoot it there anyway. They wasn't gonna be doing it for me. All I needed was like a white floor. Got my laptop set up here so I can play some music when I get started. And we have the collection all laid out. Earlier today, I was getting all the website banners ready, like the password page for mobile and desktop, and then the launch page for mobile and desktop. There's actually quite a great deal that goes into like launching. It's not just a matter of like, I'm gonna put a sick print from anywhere onto a t-shirt, call it mine, slap a logo on it, and boom, it's ready. That couldn't be further from the case. But all in all, I absolutely love it. This is my obsession. This is the thing I'm able to obsess over when I'm not on prep, when I'm not competing. Because eating food is easy. Training in the gym when you're on the off season, you got all the energy in the world is easy. But this is a whole new ball game for me. And I wanna document the process and show you like the whole sort of like journey, all the little things that happen, the highs, the lows, and all the things in between. So yeah, any support with this would obviously mean a fat great deal. But enough of that, I'm gonna get started. I'm gonna finish ironing the clothes and start taking the pictures. So just got out of the shower. I thought this would be a good opportunity to show you the hair transplant update because my hair's like all slicked back and obviously when it's like blow dried and everything, my normal hair sort of like clouds the hair transplant. So I thought this would be a good time to show you the progress. You might have already obviously seen it like throughout the video anyway. 2 to 3 months after the hair transplant, I got PRP, which is essentially plasma therapy when they take your blood, they spin it, they take the plasma out of the blood and then inject it to where the hair transplant was. And plasma has fantastic healing properties, or so they say. It's one of those things that like, there's proof that it works, but some people kind of like don't necessarily think that like plasma therapy is like, you know, the safe haven of recovery when it comes to like hair regrowth or putting plasma into a joint or like a torn like ligament or anything. But some people truly believe, and some doctors do stand by the fact that it really, really does help regeneration. Funnily enough, when I got PRP, within about a week or 2 to 3 weeks, I actually saw growth for the first time. It's probably been about 4 to 5 months since the transplant now. And as you can see, the hairs are like nicely growing in. One side will always grow faster than the other side, but inevitably, when it all sort of grows in to the hair, it will all look symmetrical and even. And to be honest, like considering the fact that I'm 26, obviously through anabolic exposure, hereditary reasons, my hair was receding, and that's just something that I couldn't avoid. My dad was bald at 21 years old. The fact that I even have hair now is a miracle. All this area is like filling in now is amazing. And then obviously when this sort of conjoins, like these pieces right here join onto my current hair, it's gonna look like a thick mother freaking bitch. And I'm gonna have good hair now until like mid 30s, I would say. Obviously there is chance of it receding even further. The hair transplant people did actually put hairs into the line further back than was receding. So I'm gonna be covered for a little bit. But if I have to do it again in like 5, 6 years, I could do it again, fill it up, and then just have good hair for the rest of my life. So that's the update 5 months in.
All right then, to end the vlog, let's have a conversation and talk about the show that we are gonna be competing in for the pro debut, because it's something I've known what show I'm gonna do for a few weeks now, ever since the conversation with Callum. And I've been very, very excited about it, just because of the fact that, as I said at the start of the video, already got a special place in my heart. And it's because, you know the place that I got my pro card? Austria? Well, Austria are actually having their first ever pro show in the country of Austria on the 9th of December. And this guy is gonna go and do it. So with the fact that obviously having, you know, experience in Austria, knowing the gym to go to, Das Gym, an incredible gym in Vienna, where I competed in before was, it's like St. Pölten or something. It's an hour from Vienna. The pro show is actually in Vienna. So I'm gonna be training at Das Gym, staying in there for probably the entirety of peak week to make the end of prep so much easier and more efficient. We're gonna be in a familiar place where the judges, I don't know if it's gonna be the same judges, but they could remember me, which might be a good thing because I got my pro card at the last pro qualifier in Austria and then doing the first pro show. It just sounds like, it just sounds right. So of course, with that in mind, we now have a game plan. We know the show, I know how long I have of the off season. I know my cruising period and how long that's sort of gonna be, because as you know, we canceled the Thailand trip. We didn't completely cancel it because obviously that would be a waste of money. And I bought a Flexi ticket. You can't receive a refund with that, but you can receive the ability to change the flight from 1 year of the original date that it was bought from, which was the 15th of December last year. So I have a year in the summertime because prep's gonna start on the 9th of September. So I'm thinking some time in summer, me and Jordy go to Thailand. We have that amazing trip. We go for 2 or 3 weeks. We completely de-stress, because you can probably tell in this video that there's a lot sort of going on
in my mind, and there's a lot of sort of like to deal with preparing for the launch and getting ready for the take flight this, and you know, conceptually what's happening over the course of this year. There is multiple clothing releases, multiple equipment releases, our first bodybuilding show, 2 meetups, our first ever expo as a company, managing making YouTube videos, managing a whole athlete regime, growing the brand itself, making sure that content is being created for all of these things. There's the brand new Hard Body Coaching app, which is going to be coming out next month, and the content has to be created for the release of that, and all the work over the past like 6 months to a year of developing that app to make it the best app that it can be has been a lot. This is the way I want to live. This pressure. This, like, sometimes I'm like in bed. I would have like done so much in the day that like that I'll be in bed and I'll be like shaking in a way. Like, because there's so much adrenaline coming from like the creative thought process from doing all these different things. And that's probably why I've been a little bit less consistent on YouTube. I'm going to give a bit of a perspective of like sort of companies that are blowing up right now that you've definitely heard the name of, but you probably only heard of them recently, but they've been around for a long time. So Young LA, for example, Young LA has been around for, I'm going to say like 5 to 7 years. I don't know the exact origin date. I don't know when it began, but it's been around for a long time. But I guarantee the first time you heard the word Young LA was about 2 years ago. Maybe a year and a half ago or a year ago. So what were they doing for the first 3 to 4 to 5 years of the company? They were grinding, they were working, they were laying the roots to be able to now do frequent clothing drops, have the funds to sponsor the top of the industry. People that charge like 5, 10 to 20,000 pound a month salary, they can pay that now, millions and millions a year in just influencer advertising, because they spent all that time growing the foundations. And that is literally what I'm doing right now. That is literally for the next 3 to 4 to 5 years. And then hopefully at the 6, 7 year mark, which is typically what happens with companies, if you give it everything, that's their sort of like next phase period. BSN, Bear Sports Nutrition, Nick Bear's supplement company, same thing happened. That company was around for so many years, like, you know, 6, 7, 8 years. And then only 2, 3 years ago, after being around for almost a decade, it finally caught wind and blew up. This is literally the dedication that has to happen when building a company. And sometimes you can be a Max Tuning and you can make sour strips and you can just blow up within your first year because you've already got an established sort of name and experience building another company, which was Max Tuning's previous clothing brand. When you have experience growing things and when you make a product that the world is yearning for, like sour sweets, which everyone loves, obviously it's a product that everyone can sort of get involved with, but when you're in a niche like lifting equipment, like when you walk in the gym, how many people have a lever belt in their hands? Probably 5%. That's the small market that we're advertising to. And then obviously in a clothing market, it's a very saturated market, especially in fitness fashion, but we are creating something pretty special, and hopefully one day we'll be able to say that we're like sort of leaders in the space. And that's my dream, and that's my goal, and that's what I'm working towards. So these tireless nights, this work, this maybe seeming a little bit stressed in the videos, sometimes it might not make sense, but eventually I promise it will. And then off that topic, back onto the show that we are competing in, that's going to be, like I said, on the 9th of December. So we have 13 weeks backtrack from that date. So prep is going to start on the 9th of September. So we have a lot of mass to build. We have a lot of food to eat, and we have a lot of work to do sort of like with business and everything before that date. Because obviously on prep, you sort of concentrate all that energy on the prep itself, and you sort of take a step back from the business development side of things. So things need to be planned and put in place. So when that time does come around and it does arise, we are sort of like ready for it in the back end, and we can just apply ourselves massively to the first ever pro show of my entire freaking life. Sick. With that being said, I'm gonna end this video here. If you enjoyed it, drop a like, turn on post notifications, and subscribe if you haven't already, because it really helps the channel grow. And I will see you in the next video. Peace.